Richard, now, just to bring Richard back again. Richard, you, I presume, know the sincerity with which Billy and many of his colleagues hold their views. It's very difficult sometimes to swallow for them and for you, but are you going to continue campaigning once, you know, assuming that this bill gets through?
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, I don't doubt that Billy and others genuinely hold these views and are opposing the legislation on the grounds of principle. But I would say, to my mind, there's something of a contradiction that this is the issue that they've broken from the government on, and didn't, for example, break with the government over cuts to child benefit or cuts to loan.
That's
parents.
Probably for another evening's debate, you know.
Okay, well, but I think it's just worth saying, I find that a substantial contradiction when we're talking about protecting children. But yeah, of course, I mean, in the case of fatal fetal abnormalities, I intend to press the amendments at report stage, because I think it is, the government are running away from an issue they could actually deal with in this legislation, even within the existing constitutional framework. And if they don't do it, these absolutely horrendous, tragic, unbelievably cruel situations where women with pregnancies they wanted, but where the child has been diagnosed with a condition which means that that child has no chance of survival, will be forced to carry that pregnancy to term or be forced to flee in exile to
Britain. But there's another one, sir, and that is that women in that circumstance, for instance, that they have to get on a plane. Mm. And whatever stigma follows that, you know, the Michael Leary...
They will be told, Sam, they will be told that what they are doing in Britain is criminal here, when in fact they are trying to deal with the most tragic circumstances imaginable. But I also think on other issues, I mean, the Constitution 43.3, the Constitution, makes a completely arbitrary distinction between health and life. In medicine, there is no distinction between health and life. And this is going to come back to haunt us. Because as the legislation is now set up, a doctor could say, if your health is threatened, you can't have a termination, and we have to wait until the health condition becomes life-threatening before you can have a termination.
But this is that's what happened in the case of
in Civita, absolutely. So Civita could still happen again under this legislation. X could still happen. I mean, the idea that you have to have three doctors, including an obstetrician, to certify whether somebody is suicidal is ridiculous.
That's something, Billy, which I find remarkable, that before the unfortunate events in Galway, that people, there was this chant that we have, you know, the best facilities for giving birth in the world, etc., etc., which was patently not true. You know, I mean, I think we